And here we go, so the program has started. But before we do that, I would like to go over the code a little bit to make sure we all understand how it works. So what I do, I go to our editor, to Spider. Straightforward. So what we do here, we create a few classes. So what is a class in Python? It is simply a template. So it contains functions or values or whatever you put there. So the first template I create, it is utility function right here. So if you can see that it is our simple utility function that we use all the time. So we define the parameter, we define the form of utility function right here. And we define our optimizing conditions. So marginal utility of consumption and so on and so forth. So we do all of that right here. As we do in class, with pencil and paper. So next, we define production function in the same way. So you define parameters that the function uses. We define functional form. And we define optimizing conditions. So nothing new here. And finally, we define equilibrium. So we put everything together. And here you can see that we solve for steady state in the same way as before. So also here we extend the model and we add government sector. That is why we have tax revenue. And finally, we calculate welfare, so very easy. It is simply our utility function that we defined before. Okay, so how the code works next? So you have a bunch of text that appears when you run the program. And importantly, right here, the code picks up parameters that you use. So what you do, you simply input your data from national income and project accounts. The model is calibrated automatically. And then you have the solution at the steady state and you have welfare. So here everything is solved. And what you get at the end, you get calibrated parameters, solution at the steady state, and welfare. So let's see how it works. So I have already started the program. So and it tests everything what you need to do. So the first thing I need to do, I need to input investment to output ratio. So here I will just input any random numbers, but the next assignment should have the numbers that you need to input. So here I will do 0.3. Government expenditure to output ratio, let's say 0.2, capital to output, let's say 0.4, and capital to income share, let's say 0.3. And average hours worked, that would be 40. And here we need to insert, yep.
If you mess up by typing the numbers into the scopes, that way you go back.
No, you need to start over, but it's very short, so it's not a problem. So what you do, you just close the window and start over. So you insert tax on labor, let's say 0.4, tax on capital 0.2, and on consumption 0.1.
So how do you get the prompt to ask you about the parameters? Is that going to happen automatically?
Yeah, parameters? Parameters are calibrated.
Yeah, how do you get the part where you put the parameters?
So the only parameters you need to put are the tax rate and the government. The all preference and technology parameters are going to be calibrated within the computer program. You don't have to do step four at all. The computer will do it for you. So it'll compute the parameter values that would give you these observations given this policy. So you do have to input the policy, but the preference and technology parameters are computed by the computer program. Okay, so you don't have to do step four. Isn't that nice?
Okay. Alright, so we inputted, so what we did so far, we inputted our data from national income and product accounts and our tax policy. That's it so far. So we input everything and here we go. So the computer has just calibrated parameters. So we have normalized A. We have alpha, beta, theta, delta. Okay, it's already calibrated for us. What it suggests now is to calculate steady state. So we simply press enter. And here we go. Here we have all steady state values. Consumption, labor supply, capital, output, wages, return on capital, and investment capital. So everything you need. Here you have welfare calculated for you. So it is negative simply because I inputted random numbers that don't make much sense. So now the program suggests you to have a tax experiment. So what you can do here, you can create, you can insert new taxes, and it will give you new welfare and new equilibrium conditions. And that's it.
And importantly for this part, we're using the calibrated parameters from the first part. Okay?
Yes.
This is the counterfactual. Let's change just the taxes, okay? See what we get.
Okay, any questions, guys? So once again, it is pretty straightforward. All the instructions are online. If you have any questions, please let me know. Okay, and one more thing I want to mention. Here I work at Anaconda Prompt. Please don't confuse it with Command Prompt in your computer. So if you open Command Prompt, it looks the same, but it's not it. Okay, please don't do that. One more thing, if you are using Mac, you will, so the procedure is the same, but you will use Anaconda Terminal. Okay, but the installation process and everything should be the same. Okay, any questions?
Okay, if I use Mac?
So if you use Mac, it's the same thing, but instead of Anaconda Prompt, it will be called Anaconda Terminal.
All right, well, I'm sure questions will come up as you start kind of learning by doing and like, oh, so don't be shy, and it should be fun. I mean, this is, let the computer do all, we can kind of know what's involved, but the computer's doing it.